Hello dear students and welcome in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what? Body movement. So from the body movement, today we will start the new point, that is parts of the skeleton. So there are so many different parts of the skeleton. With the help of that parts, the whole skeleton is getting made, okay, or the whole skeletons are having the different parts. So which are the parts of the skeleton? There are the five main parts of skeleton. The skeleton is consist of five parts. The skeleton is made up of five parts, that are skull, backbone or spine, rib cage. Next one is that limbs and girdles. Okay. So skull, backbone, rib cage, limbs and girdles, all these are five parts of skeleton. So all these parts we are going to see one by one deeply. So first, today we will start with the first part of the skeleton, that is nothing but what? Skull. Okay, that is nothing but skull. Okay. So the skull is the bony structure. The skull is the bony structure which is made up of 22 bones. The total bones present in the skull is what? 22. From the 22 bones, the skull is get made. Among the 22 bones, 8 bones forms this cranium, or we can say that what? Brain box. Okay. From the 22 bones, the 8 bones form the brain box or cranium. In that, the brain can get protected. In this cranium or in this brain box, the brain can get protected. And remaining 14 bones helps to form this shape of the face. Okay, so in this way, if 8 bones forms the brain box and the remaining 14 bones forms the face, or it helps to give the shape to the face. In this way, with the help of these 22 bones, this whole the skull is get made. And that our very delicate or our very important organs can get protected, that is nothing but what? Brain. So all these bones from the skull, that is what? 22 bones from the skull are what? Fixed. They cannot do the movement. Okay, all these bones are fixed, but only the exception is that what? Lower jaw. You can see here in the skeleton, this lower jaw we can easily move. Why is it like that? Because this lower jaw can do the movement. It is called as what? Movable joint. How it is doing joint, or how they are doing the movement, why they are performing the movement? Because this lower jaw help us to chew the food and to speak clearly. Okay, so in this way, whole the skull bones are fixed, immovable. They cannot do the movement. Only the lower jaw. There are the two types of the jaw. This is what? Upper jaw and this is lower jaw. So this lower jaw can do the movement. It can go up and down. Why? To chew the food properly and to speak it clearly. Okay, so this is first part of the skeleton, that is what? Skull. It is made from 22 bones. Okay, now we'll see the next part of the skeleton, that is nothing but what? Backbone and rib cage. So this backbone is the main axis of the skeleton. It forms the main axis of the skeleton. All the bones, whatever present in our body, all these bones are connected to this backbone. Okay, so this backbone is made up of the 33 small ring shaped bone, and that small ring shaped bones are called as what? Vertebrae. Okay, that small ring shaped bones are called as vertebrae. Next one, all these small bones, all these ring shaped bones joins together. Okay, all this you can see here, these are the ring like shape of the bones, and all these ring shaped bones you can see here, all these ring shaped bones are get connected to each other, get joins to each other, and that joins of that small bones forms the very strong column, that is called as what? Vertebral column. Okay, so that vertebrae joins together to form a strong column, which is called as what? Vertebral column. Okay, so this each ring like structure is called as what? Vertebrae.
and that all these vertebrae are joins together and then forms the very strong column, and that column is called as what? Vertebral column. And this vertebral column plays a very vital role in our skeletal system, that is what? It protects our delicate spinal cord. Okay, so if you count all these vertebrae, then these are the 33 vertebrae are present in the spinal, in the vertebral column. Okay, and from this vertebral column our very delicate spinal cord runs, and in this way what happen, our spinal cord can get protected with the help of this vertebral column. Also this backbone or the spine help us to give the support to our body. Okay, so this backbone or the spine supports our body and also it protects our spinal cord. Next one, vertebrae meet allows light movement. Okay, the joint where the vertebrae meet, you can see that between the two vertebrae there is one space, small space is there. Okay, so the point where the two vertebrae meet, that point allow the slightly movement. Okay, so this slightly movement help us to bend forward and to bend backward. Okay, so in the image you can see that how we can move, do the movement of our backbone. Why we can do the most slightly movement of our backbone? Because the place where the two vertebrae meet, it allows the slightly movement which help us to do the certain types of the movement of our backbone. So this is about what? Backbone or spine. These are the 33 ring shaped bones which are called singular. Each bone is called as what? Vertebrae. That vertebrae joins together and then from the vertebral column which helps to protect the spinal cord and give the support to the body. Let's move for the next part of the skeleton, that is what? The rib cage. Okay, 12 pairs of the thin curved bone. It is also the bony structure which is made up from the 12 pairs of curved and thin bones. Okay, how the bones are in the rib cage? 12 pairs of thin and curved bone. Okay, so see here, you can see here, this is the all ribs. Okay, all these are the 12 pairs. It means what? If we are counting in a pair, it is 12. Then what is the total number of the ribs are present? That is what? 24. 24 ribs are present in the rib cage, and how many pairs? 12 pairs of ribs are present in the rib cage. How is their shape? They are thin and curved bones. Next one, this rib cage protects our heart and the lungs. So these 12 pairs of the ribs forms the rib cage which helps our internal organ, that are what? Heart and the lungs. Okay, so protects the heart and the lungs. So these 12 thin and the curved shaped ribs form the rib cage which helps to protect our internal organ, the heart and the lungs. Next one, join the backbone at the back. All these ribs, all these 12 pairs of the ribs are joined to the backbone from the back side. Okay, from the back side, all these 12 pairs of the ribs are joined to the backbone. Okay, next one is that first 10 pairs are joined with the sternum in the front. Okay, see here, these are the 12 pairs of the ribs. All the 12 pairs of the ribs are connected to the backbone from which side? From the back side. But from the front side, the first 10 ribs are connected to the one bone, and the name of that bone is what? Sternum. Okay, see, this is one bone and the name of that bone is called sternum. It is called as sternum, or also it is called as what? Chest bone or breast bone. So 12 pairs of the ribs, first 10 pairs of the ribs are connected to the, are joined to this sternum from the front side to from this rib cage. So these 10 pairs, the first 10 pairs of the ribs are connected to the sternum. It is also called as what? Chest bone or the breast bone. Why they are connected to the sternum? To form this cage like structure. Next one, the last 2 pairs of ribs are floating ribs. Here you can see that these are the last 2 pairs of the ribs. Here I will show you. These are the last two pairs of the ribs. Okay, from the back they are connected to the backbone, but from the front side they are free. You can see here, from the front they are free. Why? That is the reason they are called as what? Floating ribs. Okay, so the last two pairs of the ribs from the back, they are connected to the backbone, but from the front side they are free. They are not connected to any bone, and that is the reason that last two pairs of the ribs are called as floating ribs. So in this way, these 12 pairs of the ribs forms the rib cage, which helps to protect the heart and the lungs. Why they joins together? To form this rib cage. All the 12 pairs are connected to the backbone from the back side. The first 10 pairs of the ribs are connected to the sternum, which is also called a chest bone or the breast bone, and the last two pairs of the ribs, rib cage, are called as floating ribs. Why? Because they are connected only from the back side, but from the front side they are free, and that is the reason they are called as what? Floating ribs. So up till now we have discussed about the three parts of the skeleton. That is, we have discussed about the skull, also we have discussed about the backbone, and also we have discussed about the ribs. Okay, so this is all about today. We will meet in the next video and we will discuss the remaining parts of the skeleton. And for today, thank you.